Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. For today's video is my new daily use item, a triple zipper pouch. I found out that it is very handy to use for my everyday carry because it's shoulder free. For front pocket, I always store my keychain, car remote and coin purse. For middle one, I can put my slim notebook and pen. For the back, I place my phone. And I design in-between pocket to store for quick access use, such as Metro Pass card or membership card. And let's see how I made this. First of all, I need to sky all ends of the cassette, so it will be easily to be flattened. It is very useful for zip stopper position. In this project, I plan to make it all simple as possible. Just only essential things. So no edge pen or less skiving. Draw lines and make holes for all round zip opening position. Use the zip itself to measure the opening and must add 1 cm extra for both ends. To cut the zipper, just use cutter cut from the middle to outside. If use scissor, it may affect its blade sharpness. My simple trick to install for a straight zipper. Can use ruler to align for all zipper teeth in line. Then place the leather piece start from the middle. And then the opposite side. In this figure, this is very important note, especially when you need to work with zipper. Be always set your rules about which zipper teeth side to be default. For me, I always set left side to be a starter, 1 tooth below. Seek for straight line on the zipper fabric. Normally it's 7.5 mm from the middle as reference line, and roll that line over the letter edge through the chamfer corner. Stick the straight line first, then pleat the corner. scratch all these areas because they need to stitch from underside then flip and turn out. They need to scratch a bit shorter than the stitching offset to prevent seeing the scratch line. Now I draw for the pocket joiner stitch line on first side of 3rd and 4th panel. The joining panel will be set up panel 2 and 3, then 4 and 5. This is weak point of the stitch joining method. When oftenly used, it will be tear off some days. I recommend using rivets to solve the problem. For next, the important one, panel 1 and 2 will be stitched together, also 5 and 6, but it must stitch from inside and turn out. So for set of 1 and 2, you must dodge panel 3. So when you place 1 and 2 together, it needs to use clipper for better control. And all these process have to apply to set up panel 5 and 6 too. In this part, if you have sewing machine, you can also use for faster. After flipping out, some leather may cause wrinkle. Some may not, depends on what you use, but you need to remove glue stain and reshape by using bone folder and smooth mallet for quite a while. And now it's about to join the set of front and back together. Middle part join is a bit difficult due to its thickness. Don't worry, you can do it well. previously when I mentioned about the simple default rule. That will help you here. I make the zipper 1 cm longer as standard, but you can also make it longer for easier version. And after slot in the zip puller, you need to zip them all the way down for closing it. Then open up the zipper entrance and then put the zip puller back again. So you will have the zipper being closed on both ends. This time I choose not to use metal zipper and lock, but I choose using thread looping as lock. And now the last stitching position with tiny space for zipper end. Thank you all for watching. I hope you like my videos, and if you want to know what I'm going to do next, you can have a peek at my Instagram. Like, comment, or subscribe. I'm so glad you do that. Happiness be with you. See you next time.